Hello and good afternoon, friends. Welcome to the CEC Edisit Live Lecture. Dear friends, catering to your needs by introducing sub-subjects, introducing such topics which are important for you. The topics which sometimes you find difficult to talk to, or sometimes we find difficult to find the in books. Dear friends, in this session today, we would be talking on tourism and Indian environment. We would be discussing on the tourism as well as Indian environment, how they are related, what kind of connection they have. So dear friends, we would like to tell you all that for this session we have once again with us in our studios renowned academician Professor R.B. Singh. Professor Singh is an academician in Department of Geography, Delhi School of Economics, University of Delhi, as well as I would like to tell you all that he is a vice president of International Geographical Unit, and his experience of course would help us in knowing and understanding the topic tourism and Indian environment. So first of all, I would like to welcome our guest, Professor R.B. Singh. Sir, welcome to the Edisit lecture.
Thank you, Gitika ji. Dear viewers, today we are going to discuss tourism and Indian environment. Tourism is a important aspects of regional development. It plays a very important role for welfare of the people, welfare of the community. Many terms emerged in recent years: ecotourism, green tourism, sustainable tourism. We'll try our best to see different terms, you know, during my discussion. I would like to discuss, and this discussion relates to Indian environment. First of all, I would like to say that the impact of tourism has enormous on economic development, on environment, on social development, and it is opening up a tremendous opportunity like business, trade, capital investment, creating jobs, entrepreneurship for the workforce, and also protecting our cultural heritage or values. If you will see the data here, I would like to put before you a few important statistics. And travel and tourism generated US$7.6 trillion, means 10% of the global GDP. So you can understand from your own perception the type of contribution we are getting from tourism sector in the development of GDP. And it creates 277 million jobs in all over the world. And if you will consider the total job, you know, it creates the one job out of 11 jobs in the global economy as per the data of 2014. Recent years, you know, have been a lot of focus in different countries. Tourism also provides foreign exchange earning to a particular country, and so that is why many states, many countries, many provinces, many regions declaring tourism as an industry. So it is growing at a faster rate. If you will see the continuous data of the last few years, you can find the continuous development of these sectors, and it also provides the increase or development of other sectors, allied sectors like automotive, financial services, healthcare, and it is expected that tourism sector continues to grow in future, and total contribution of GDP expected to increase by 3.7% in our country. New destinations and investment opportunity will also continue to emerge in tourism, becomes increasingly affordable across developing country. But in recent years, you can find tourism used to bring enormous impact on our environment. And so that is why we are also much conscious about promoting tourism as a green tourism or sustainable tourism. Here, through this diagram, I would like to bring before you various factors driving growth of tourism. You know, it increases rising middle class and increasing income levels. This also tourism provide increase in business travel, increase in awareness of travel options. You can find also the improvement in infrastructures, because the many states would like to have the more tourism, and so they have to improve the infrastructure. Many government initiatives are coming up. Then, you know, several state governments, TV channels and tourism magazines promoting tourism through the websites and offering packages, availability of better deals and packages, tours and international sites has contributed to the growth. So these are the some of the important driving forces, you know. Even this can be linked with the business travel in India, better road or infrastructure facility, because tourists, foreign tourists or even Indian tourists, they need the flights, facility, improve road facility, sanitation facilities. Then, you know, apart from that, various initiatives and campaigns such as Incredible India, you will remember, you know, Atithi Devo Bhav have helped to promote the tourism in our country. So, various factors, many factors coming through the market forces and some other due to the government initiatives. Now, hospitality industry has become a very, very important popular in our country. Now, I would like to bring before you a few important statistics. Through this slide, I would like to put before you the whole scenarios of tourism in India. If you consider foreign tourist arrival in 2014, it is 7.7 million. Growth of foreign tourist arrival in 2014, 10.6%. Foreign exchange earning from tourism, it is 12,000 million. Tourism economy consists 6.6% of the GDP. Support 7.7% of the total employment opportunity. Only 22.57 million arrivals in India. If you compare the other smaller even country, they have a more arrival. So this figure we have to increase through various means and strategy. At the end, we'll try to also see some perspectives in this contest. So, broadly speaking, if you will consider the world tourism, our rank is very low, and India constitutes 38th in the world. It is a very low. No doubt, national mission for tourism, pilgrimage, rejuvenation and spiritual augmentation, a scheme was promoted with money investing of rupees 10 million. Swadesh Darshan scheme has been also very, very popular. Through this diagram, I would like to put before you the contribution of tourism in Indian GDP, and you can see here the 2006 to 2011, it was 4.6%, but after 12, it is almost growing at a 8% in increase contribution of in the GDP. So continuously, you know, 2006, 4.6% contribution, but now since 2012, contributing to the 8%, it is quite a big jump, you know. Then you can find also the direct contribution, indirect contribution, and in recent years we have the more direct contribution coming from the tourism sector. Now, I would like to put before you the resources for tourism in India, particularly the environmental resources in our country, and I would like to put geographical and cultural diversity of India. We have a snow-clad zone in the whole Himalayan region from the north, from the west to east. Then we have the various fairs and the festivals, rich cultural heritage, the monuments, cultural monuments, then some other cultural festivals, the palaces, and so that is why the such region, temples, mosques, and several religious places are also attracting lot of tourists all over the world. So we have diverse environment, humid in the north, east side, then we have west side, some dry condition. We have a long coastal areas, you know, like almost 7,800 kilometer long coastal line. And so it provides a lot of opportunity for tourists to visit beaches and the coastal areas, coastal landscape. We have arts and architectures, many monumental attractions. Here I would like to put one of the very important monuments like Taj Mahal. You can see this monument is attracting a very substantial proportion of a population globally, and also the nationally, lot of people visit this important monument at Agra. Apart from that, we have the Agra fort, is also very, very important. It was built during the Shah Jahan time. Then, you know, we have the many religious sites. Here I would like to put before you the Sangam on Allahabad, and you might be knowing that we have the Kumbh, Ardh Kumbh at Sangam, attracting not only the people all over the pilgrimage, all over the country, but also attracting lot of people all over the world. Apart from that, historically, we have been lot of the medicinal plants, gardens, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, attracting a lot of the, they have the natural treatment of various diseases. So people from India and even outside, they come for the health treatment in such, you know, localities. Several products you can see in the mountainous areas, such medicinal plants, we have a lot of a scope, but still we are not able to utilize in our country. If you globally speaking, we have the 7%, 8% total contribution in the global market coming through these medicinal plants. But if you consider China, China contributes around 27-28% of the total medicinal plant market. So we have to increase these aspects. Several small scale handicraft industries in the forest, near the forest area, mountainous area, desert area, everywhere. It can be linked also with the various type of resources available in our country, you know, from the desert or the from the mountain or the forest ecosystem. Eastern India, we have a long coastal line, two coast of peninsula with rich biodiversity, estuaries and backwater ecosystem. We have the unparalleled backwater ecosystem and dependent socio-cultural groups, fishing community, typical fishing community. You can find a lot of differences in eastern coast and the western coast, but both sides you can find the fishing community. Western side, the more richer fishermen, but on the other hand, eastern side, more poor fishermen. Here now you can see this, the how they are constructing boat houses using local resources, local materials, local talents, and tourists used to pay a very substantial amount of money for staying even in one night. Even during the season, they have to pay the around 10,000 rupees for one room. So, using the local material, local resources, and utilizing the potential market from the tourists, even local people are getting lot of benefit from this. Now you can see here the backwater, how rich biodiversity in this backwater ecosystem, in our Kerala backwater system. We have the plateau characterized by a steppe of savanna and humid mesothematic thermic forest, and dependent local people, indigenous people on these minor forest products. They experience very traditionally, they have the cattle rearing, a collection of minor forest products, and such products provide livelihood security of the people living in that area. And tourists are attracted by such, you know, typical human activity available in such plateau region. Then focusing on the mountainous region, it's a very beautiful, you know, you can see the panoramic view of Himalayan glaciers and the forest. This photograph belongs to Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserves. Now you can see this, the beautiful gardens in the Kashmir, Dal Lake. Even Dal Lake provides a tremendous opportunity for local people to get benefit from the tourist. Lot of domestic and foreign tourists, they go to Dal Lake, they stay in the boat houses, and people get maximum benefit from that. Now I would like to put one two important statistics here. You can see this total tourist in Himachal Pradesh, how growing, almost the 14% increase continuously from 2006 to 2011. Other hand, I am taking the one example of Uttarakhand. Here you can see almost also the total tourist Uttarakhand continuously increasing from 2006 to 2010. So everywhere in the Himalaya, particularly in Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Uttarakhand very famous for pilgrimage. Lot of the foreign tourists even visit the Himachal Pradesh or Jammu and Kashmir. If you will consider the seasonality of tourism industry in Himalaya, we have April is a very important season, April to almost the June. Then we have decrease of the tourist, and then again we have the increase during the October. So these are the very important months providing attraction for the tourist. Through this diagram, I would like to put before you investment in tourism in Indian states, and you can see that Uttarakhand got a larger share, 1.4% of the total, 48% of the total budget on tourism. On the other hand, then followed by Karnataka 0.80, then Maharashtra 0.62. We have the less investment in Andhra Pradesh, 0.09% of the total budget. Then Uttar Pradesh also 0.14, Madhya Pradesh 0.22, Rajasthan almost the similar, Rajasthan, West Bengal, Himachal Pradesh 0.28. It is very important that we have to increase the investment in other states so that we can have the more attraction of the tourist. I would like to take up some case study And particularly, I would like to highlight from the history of pilgrimage tourism in the Himalaya. The whole Himalayan region has an important spiritual meaning. One or another, you know, particularly the Hindi, several you can find the sacred places for the Hindus. It is estimated that pilgrimage to the sanctuaries in the Himalayas started between the 4th and 2nd century. The earliest written evidence for pilgrimage to the Himalaya is during the even Mahabharata time, 1st century BC, you can find Jamunotri, Kedarnath, Gangotri, Badrinath. These are very important pilgrimage, tourist places. Now you can see this, the several, places in this, the Himalayan region, even hill stations. Due to the beautiful environment and very good natural beauty, the Britishers established several hill stations. Many hill stations are the following, like Shillong, Darjeeling, Nainital, Almora, Ranikhet, Dehradun, Mussoorie, Chakrata, Simla, Srinagar, Mori. These are the some of the other, these are the elevation. If you will see, the elevation is almost the starting from 1400 to almost 2200 meter. Modern tourism in the 21st century. Modern mass tourism in the Himalayan region started in 1950 after Sir Edmund Hillary, important travelers and mountaineers, Tenzing Norway, climbed the Mount Everest and made the region popular in other parts of the world that had until then more or less ignored by the region. After the Indian-Chinese border war in 1962, a huge number of roads were built in the Indian part of the Himalaya. Until 1970, almost 10,000 kilometers of roads. So these roads, provided a better infrastructure facility to the for the tourist visiting such area. Now I would like to say that such inappropriate, even sometime constructing the roads, people or the government used the dynamites, and it provided a lot of instability in the regions, bringing landslides and various other land degradation processes. After these roads were also opened up for the foreign tourists, the regions close to the road experienced enormous growth in tourism. In Ladakh, like number of visitors increased tremendously. Then, because upper part of the Himachal and Ladakh was linked with the road, and so it provided the cheap transport facility for the tourist. The Himalaya offers the modern tourist a widespread range of possibility. The activity ranged from visiting the unique cultural attraction, hiking, skiing, to the more adventurous types of tourism. I would like to take a case study of wetlands. Wetland mostly in the Changtang region, in Himalaya, wetlands of the Ladakh Himalaya particularly I would like to mention, but in other part of the Himalaya you can find the several famous wetlands. Average altitude around 4700 meter, then temperature vary between 27 degree to minus 40 degree centigrade. It is a unique and fragile ecosystem. Fresh water as well as brackish water, varying salinity and different type of sizes. I would like to put here a case study of Sumori, Twin Lakes, Soker and a star spoke. So now you can see the photograph of Sumeri, how it is a beautiful natural environment. Naturally, this can attract a very substantial tourist, not only foreign tourists but also the local tourists, like Indian tourists. Variety of biodiversity, you know, in this region: black-necked crane, bar-headed geese, Himalayan marmot, kyang kyang. Apart from that, you can find the typical type of herbs in that area, and people go even for the treatment: sea buck thorn forest. But in recent years, we are getting major threats to these wetlands. We have overgrazing. People used to get the free grazing land. And so here I would like to mention the tragedy of commons. A very important theory of Hardin, you know, is visible here, because due to shortage of agriculture land and other economic opportunity like industry, people are going for more and more livestock population, because they can get the free grazing land in that area. And so in recent years intensive overgrazing phenomena can be found. Second, pollution. Many tourists are coming through vehicles, causing problem for the region. Generally, such region is known for no pollution or very little pollution area, but now due to the vehicle concentration we have, because we do not have the controlled tourism. Many places we have the controlled tourism and control, you know, movement of vehicles in that area, but it is not true in this region. Tourism as such is a very important activity, and you can find the camps and waste, variety of camps, a waste generated due to this. Also, it is found that we are getting sign and signals of climate change in this region. So climate change is also important threat. It may create the lake outburst flood, you know, like it is known as the GLOF, glacier lake outburst flood. Then I would like to go to the another important point, particularly taking into consideration the ecotourism. Ecotourism is considered is a very important for wetland conservation. And even in Himalaya, ecotourism is a very important, you know, activity for wet, for conservation, forest conservation. Ecotourism can be seen for improving economic condition of the people, but fragile environment used to bring lot of enormous pressure on environment. It is a unique cultural heritage area, and so ecotourism can be linked with this. Now you can see here ecotourism as a tool for wetland conservation, and money likely to spend per day, you can see it varies from 250 to 1000 rupees. Places of a stay of tourist, you know, we have the personal tents, guest houses. Home stay is also very, very popular in this area, home stay. Now I would like to take the little lower altitude area, view of Dharamsala. You can see this also attracting a lot of tourists due to the concentration of the Tibetan locality and headquarters of Dalai Lama. Now you can see this, the mountains, rocky mountain, lot of forest, grasslands, and during the winter we have the snow clad zone. A snow bound difficult area, then we also get the disaster prone areas, earthquake, floods, and the roads. One can see the rainfall induced risk in this area. I would like to tell you that Himalaya used to receive highest per unit availability of water, and so we have where we have the more overgrazing, we have lot of the problem of erosion, rock falls, land subsidence, land slips, variety of other land degradation processes one can see. You can see this photograph, rainfall induced rock slide at Bhagsu Nag Dharamsala. Another photograph, you know, a Gaddi tribe of Kangra wearing a unique cap with Monal bird's fur. Monal is a street bird of Himachal Pradesh. It is a very famous, so the you can find the many wildlife, a small scale and even local level wildlife sanctuary having the Monal. Now I would like to take the one two important statistics here. I would like to examine Indian and foreign tourist at Dharamsala town, and here you can see this, the foreign tourist in 1997 it was the more 98, but recent years foreign tourists are not coming, little bit decline, not so substantial decline, but little decline, you know. But domestic tourists, if you see the Indian tourists, almost continuously constant since 1997 to 2011. Vehicles, if you see the vehicles, so now we have the increase of vehicles, means due to the better infrastructure facility, people are taking vehicles for traveling to Dharamsala from far distance places, particularly the people from Delhi, Haryana, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh. I would like to link tourism with different sources of livelihood. I would like to tell that agriculture, horticulture, a typical agricultural system also attracts the tourists. Horticulture activity, animal husbandry, dairying, fishing, poultry, these are the important source of livelihood for the coming from the tourism. A small scale industry, mini hydro power, also attracting the some tourist. Forestry, we have the World Bank project also very famous in the nearby Kangra area. The government sector and business, migrated laborers coming from Chhattisgarh, MP, Bihar, household industry, stone cutting, traditional art and craft, rented room, pickle makings. These are the important sources of livelihood for local people, and these livelihoods activity can be linked with tourism, because tourism need hotels, temples, art and handicrafts, shoemaking, shawl weaving. It provides a lot of opportunity to the people in that area. I would like to mention here the Butiko Weaver Association, generally run by the women. These women are now, earlier they were only protecting the tree and all. You can find the Mahila Mandal in every village, every block level or the district level, Mahila Mandal. These Mahila Mandals are now diversifying their activity and they are moving towards the variety of processing industry. Now you can see this, the variety of livelihood of tourism in cooking is very, very important in the Himalayan areas. Many tourists used to come for learning how to cook Indian food, you know, and several such establishments you can find in Himachal Pradesh. Ayurveda houses, then the home stay is a very, very important industry. People are getting a lot of benefit with a small investment. The people can get the continuous earning from the tourism sector in such area. And so that is why I would like to here summarize the tourism related livelihood option. It is not applicable only in the Himalayan and Highland area, but other region also you can find, like health resorts and other tourist activity. Due to the land use changes, building and hotel construction are increasing. You can find this not only in the Himalaya, but you can go to the south, like in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, you can find the such livelihood options available to the people living in that area. Shops, bakery, fruit shops, other confectionery, item shop, flower shop, gift shop, clothes, accessory, along with Tibetan special market, you know, particularly this is very famous market in Dharamsala, at central point for the tourist. But you know, everywhere. And so in recent years, tourism, rural tourism is attracting substantial tourists, and even government are state government and the central government, they are promoting several types of the tourist circuits, you know, linking with the it can be linked, and already they are, it is being linked with several Buddhist sites and then other habits, the cultural habit of the people, like a food habit, even the different rural musical instruments can be linked with this. Then dairy businesses. Dairy business along with vegetable demand is increasing, providing benefit to the local growers and livestock. Poultry rearing is also livelihood option for the local people, local community, because important characteristics of ecotourism is to provide benefit to the community. If people, local people are not getting benefit, it means it is not ecotourism. And so that is why it is very important for private sector, the policy makers, local community to involve even the business houses, to involve the local people in this whole process. Now you can see the traditional medicine sellers at Dharamsala area. You can find the such different types of like vendors in many parts of our country. Even a traditional rural artisans of northern India, you know, those who are involved in the woodwork or iron related work or the building construction related activity, even they prepare the utensils with soil, mud. You can see this, the one local person cleaning ears for a foreigner at Kotwali Market, Dharamsala. So, you know, these are very small things, but it attracts a lot of the tourism in our country. A special wooden fruits in Bhagsunag Market, you can many people, tourists from abroad or even within a country, they try to carry such type of the local souvenir or gift for their family or for their relatives. A man from hill region sell medicinal vegetable at also Dharamsala at Kachari. Pilgrimage, I told you, since centuries you can find in India people and community moving from one place to another. Here I would like to mention for cultural purposes, four dhams you might be knowing, Badrinath or the Rameswaram in the south, Dwarika in the west, Puri in the east side. These all are the very important sites of pilgrimage tourism. Then in recent years you can find for the Jain, Buddhist, even Ajmer attracting a lot of tourists, Rajasthan, you know, this Pushkar, the Brahma temple attracted a very substantial amount of proportion of tourists from abroad. Now you can see here pilgrimage from Punjab, religious idols for sale at Kangra. These idols are not only purchased by the local people but also many foreign tourists. Here you can see the one of the Tibetan outlet at Bhagsunag showcasing slogan of free Tibet, and they sell a lot of the materials, hookahs at Bhagsunag market in MacLeod Ganj area. These are very items are very popular among tourists. In recent years, adventure tourism has become a very important instrument for the foreign tourist. First time paragliding World Cup held at Birbiling in Kangra, October 2015. This is one of the best paragliding site of the world. You know, you can compare with the other places. A Tibetan population is residing in Bir along with local community known for its monasteries and Tibetan culture. Local community livelihood depend on these tourists and Tibetans. Homestay, guest houses, catering and restaurants businesses is flourishing after World Cup announcement. It has become a good place for education, not only for the local but for the Phlang Phrang area in Chota and Bara Bangal region. You can see the paragliding World Cup. After the announcement of this World Cup, many establishments were started in and around area. Paragliders at landing sites. So locally people, lot of local people get benefit because they provide the various type of services to the local the tourist. But in recent years we are getting a lot of problems, maybe environmental problems, social problems. So on the one hand, we are getting economic benefit. It provides, tourism is also considered as a important aspects of regional development. But on the other hand, you can find the traffic problem, traffic jam, you know, because we do not have control of traffic. Sometime people used to say, control tourism is also the one of the important strategy local government can adopt for reducing influx of tourists in a particular area if it exceeds carrying capacity of the region. Urbanization. In Himalaya, you can find massive construction activity because tourists need hotels, motels, other type of the different type of dhabas. They need the some like for medicinal plants, the some processing units, and so you can find increase of urbanization, building structures at Bhagsunag, and sometime without taking into consideration of the landscape structure, they built such, you know, hotels or motels. In this context, I would like to suggest that we can understand landscape synthesis of the area before going for any construction activity. We can take the data and statistics from remote sensing, aerial photographs. We can put in our GIS system, and we can prepare land suitable for tourism, hotel, motel, or variety of tourist needs. Here I would like to bring before you several critical issues for tourism in our India. I would like to tell you that many countries, even Sri Lanka, Southeast Asian country, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, they are attracting more tourists than us. We have to think that what we can do for promoting tourism in our country. And first thing I would like to say, the improvement in infrastructure facility. Infrastructure relates to road facility, air transport facility is very important. Even the foreign tourist coming from far distance, you know, country, they do not have much time to spend. They would like to go quickly to the several touristic places. I would like to mention here that particularly Uttarakhand area, where air facilities, air transport is limited to a very, very places, you know, selected places. We have to improve in such infrastructure facility and link to the religious places. Closer to Kedarnath, closer to Badrinath, closer to Almora. If we can have air transport facility, we can attract more tourists. Law and order problem. Second, law and order problem is a very, very problematic in our country. Any misbehavior, mishappening with tourist, you know, goes a very bad message all over the world. And so, sometimes people avoid coming to that area. So, we have to improve the law and order situation. And you can find very close, positive relationship between the law and order situation and the influx of tourists. Where better law and order facility, tourists prefer to go there. Visa problem. Tourists, they can spend money. You know, they do not want that they can go for arranging visa, for transport facility, for ticket to Taj. You know, they would like to have a full package for that, and such packaging facility is missing in our country. So we have to improve this packaging facility, linking with the private sector. Private sector also can get the benefit, and the country can get the benefit. I think it is a win and win situation for all of us. So, visa on arrival is a very, very good step, and I think due to this facility, we have also seen increase in the tourist. Sanitation and environmental pollution problem. It is also called tourism destroy tourism. If you know, due to tourism, if we have no better infrastructure facility, or we have enormous pressure on environment, we have more solid waste problem, then tourists will not come to that area. And so that is why I can say tourism destroy tourism. So we have to promote such a strategy so that more and more tourists should come. Budget allocation, still our budget allocation is very, very less. Global average is 6.8%, we have only 1% of the total public spending. So we have to improve. I have presented the one table, and Uttarakhand, you know, of the total budget of Uttarakhand is more than 1%, otherwise many places it is less than 1%. So we have to improve. Even central government, they should improve spending on tourism sector. Capital expenditure, if you will see, 6.4% of the GDP. As a global average, if you will see, it is 11.8. So our, you know, capital expenditure is 6.4%. It is very less, almost half of the world, you know. Tax, even sometimes high tax charge from the tourists in India. Many places we have the lot of fee and all. In foreign country, they keep very minimum charges, so this tax can be reduced. Even tax on hotels, tax on other, you know, food expenditure can be reduced. Tax paid in Asian country, it is a 3 to 6%. Indian motel charge about 40% of the total tax. If you will compare Thailand, if you will go to Malaysia or Singapore, they charge less, even Sri Lanka. Then I would like to bring before you tourism-induced environmental impact. Such impacts are more in mountainous region, but you can find all over the country. Environmental degradation. Any area where we have the more high influx of tourists, we have more pressure on environment. Due to construction activity, even the pollution problem, vehicles, influx, you know, vehicle concentration. And so even the tourist places like Manali, we should go for controlled tourism. Like Bhutan, you see, they have a very limited, you know, quota for the tourist, and they allow only a particular number of tourists, you know, to their country. Depletion of the forest, because forests are considered a very, very important site for the tourist. They use for bonfire, for trekking. So such skiing, such activities are posing enormous threat to our forest resources. And if we have the, due to the construction activity, we have more destruction of forest, means more erosion. We have the more erosion problem. And due to the erosion, we have loose materials coming to the water bodies, and you can find that drying up of the water resources in the area. And if we water is not available, then we have problem of agricultural land, you know, they can also face the problem. Waste issue, waste management is a very important challenge for the tourist, and we must reduce waste so that tourism will not destroy tourism. Tourism may promote tourism, and so that is why many people, many places in foreign country, they have certain tax, green tax on from the tourist, and the money available from such tax can be expended on the improving the infrastructure facility for cleaning work, for waste disposal, for resource recovery from the waste. So these are the some of the important, particularly large number of tourists, and so that is why in one place. So one important strategy people use to suggest the disseminate tourist. Amount of solid is also increasing, overloaded areas and growing stockpiles of garbage could create water crisis, pollution attributable to expedition, tracking, camping activity of trackers. So not only directly posing the threat to the forest, but also indirectly, you know, posing threat to our sustainability, because through the erosion or variety of other activity. Garbage includes the food, glass, clothes, stain, dead bodies. You know, in many places, we do not have the collection, dustbin. You know, it is very important for the local level government to install the dustbin in various area for waste collection. Cultural issues is a very, very important. Loss of the culture through the commodification, standardization, loss of authenticity. Many people consider loss of the cultural value because people lose their traditional the dressage. Even sometimes the food habit has changed in many areas due to the contact of the tourists. Adaptation of tourist demands, they move towards that. Climate, tourism and sustainable development, this is also linked. Like, you know, climate provides the basis for mountain tourism, and so that is why environment, Indian environment. But we have the climate change is coming up, climate change and disaster restricts the future development action. You can find the variety of, you know, disasters happened, glacier lake outburst flood in several potential sites you can find in Himachal Pradesh and the Sikkim. And I think we have to also reduce this. So disaster risk reduction, DRR, has become a very, very important instrument for decision making. You can find the variety of, disasters like Leh, Uttarakhand disasters, you know, Kedarnath tragedy. And even sometime, our very famous Kaziranga National Park, all this biodiversity is threatened due to the such the flooding. You can see this, the how people adopt. And so local control of tourism is very important. A spatial limitation, activity limitation, temporal limitation, cultural limitation. And ultimately, we have to promote the sustainable mountain tourism or sustainable tourism. So here, you know, I would like to stop here. And ultimate strategy is sustainable tourism involving the community and local people. Thank you.
With this note, thank you, sir. Thank you so very much for giving us a productive session. Dear friends, we would be meeting again very soon and would be discussing more and on some other topic very soon. Till then, take care. Goodbye. Thank you, sir. Thank you so very much.